Hi everyone, welcome back to the Simply Maker channel. In today's video, I'll guide you to install Tuya Cloudcutter on a Raspberry Pi 02W for wirelessly flashing Tuya IoT devices. The key difference from installing it on other Raspberry Pi models is, the Pi 0 doesn't come with an Ethernet port. This means you'll have to take some extra steps to configure the Pi 0 to access the local network using a USB port connected to your computer. So let's get started. Start with building a Raspberry Pi image with the Raspberry Pi Imager. Now it's important to set the initial OS settings, so you can easily access it via SSH. Choose a host name that is simple to remember. Choose a username and password. Enter your home Wi-Fi credential. Go to the Services tab and enable SSH. Then save the setting and go ahead and write the image. Now you can close Raspberry Pi Imager. Open the micro SD card contain the boot image. Use a text editor to edit config.txt and cmdline.txt files. Now you can unmount the SD card and insert it into the Raspberry Pi. Connect a micro USB cable from your computer to the Raspberry Pi data port. Give it a moment to boot up completely. The first boot might take a bit longer. Go to Network in System Preference. You'll see the device show up as an RNDIS Ethernet gadget. Choose Configure IP4 manually. Pick an IP address that is different from your local gateway. Go to Sharing and enable Internet Sharing for the Ethernet gadget. Now you can SSH to the Pi via terminal. Use the username and hostname you previously set while creating the Pi image. Update the packages using the following command. Install Network Manager. Edit the dhcpcd.conference file. Add the following line to the end. Use the following command to edit the networkmanager.conf file. Replace the content with the following lines. Then save the file and reboot the Raspberry Pi. After rebooting, SSH back to the Pi. Continue the process by installing Docker with the following command. Next, install Git. This will allow us to clone the Tuya Cloudcutter repository directly from GitHub. Finally, install Tuya Cloudcutter. That's it. Once the installation is complete, you can run Tuya Cloudcutter to flash your IoT device. I've included all the download links and command lines in the written instructions, so you to conveniently copy and paste them into your terminal. You can check them out through the link in the video description. In the next video, I'll guide you through using Tuya Cloudcutter to wirelessly flash Tuya IoT devices. Make sure you're subscribed and have hit the bell icon to stay updated with the latest uploads. If you have any questions, feel free to drop them in the comments. I'm here to assist. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching.